President Marcos early this week said there's no decision yet on the United States' request for the Philippines to temporarily house Afghan nationals as they wait to be given their special immigrant visas to the U.S. Marcos says the proposal is still being studied, citing various concerns, including security and even logistics. Now, these Afghans work for the U.S. government or military, mostly as translators, are seeking to leave the country as they face threats from the Taliban after the U.S. withdrew from Afghanistan. Let's discuss this issue with Diego Jose Ramos. He's a tech entrepreneur who believes the country should open its doors to Afghans in need. DJ, thank you and welcome to Top Story.
Good afternoon, Stanley. Thank you for having me.
All right. Why is it important for the Philippines to extend support to Afghan refugees by acceding to this supposed request by the United States? What do you think?
Stanley, there's a big reason aside from, because in history, we have done that in the past together with the Jew during the Holocaust. I mean, and also in line with the current campaign of the new launched platform for the DOT, which is Love in the Philippines. I think it's just, we just have to take a look at a different lens on how to take effort, active effort, really to show some love to the world and have this positivity come to our country. It is also our humanitarian obligation to help them, because as they sacrifice their lives and their families to do good work during their service with American and NATO.
Okay, now your group, Go Cordillera AI, is making an appeal to our lawmakers, which are currently tackling this request. What has transpired so far? Have you submitted your position?
Yes, Stanley. Our group tends to solve the disconnect between farmers and consumers. So our goal is just to put them all together. Mm-hmm. We built this under the spirit of social enterprise. So we built farming communities. That's our goal. With that heart, I mean, we cannot just look back and turn a blind eye to this compelling issue on humanitarian cause for Afghan refugees.
Okay, now some of the apprehensions raised against this move, citing lack of transparency with the supposed deal between the U.S. and the Philippines as regards the processing of these Afghan refugees whose final destination is really the United States. Now, what do you have to say about this?
Stanley, that is really very true. We have to know, everyone has to know, that the reason why there are no lot of documents to support this, because when the U.S. troops left Afghanistan long ago, they burned all documents as well as the biometric machines, and some of them were sequestered by the Taliban government currently. And of course, with that, they're currently exposed for danger. It takes a lot of time for the U.S. Army to vet for this. So they are appealing to us that we become a country, a host country, while they are continuously vetting the list of these Afghan refugees. Okay. I mean, we'd like to help, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay, now you already mentioned and tackled this a while ago. The Philippines has in fact hosted Jewish refugees during World War II and Vietnamese asylum seekers also at the height of the Vietnam War. Now, what opportunity, aside from hospitality and humanitarian reasons, are you seeing that the country will receive by extending help and accommodating the Afghan refugees, albeit temporarily?
I think, Stanley, aside from the fact that these Afghan refugees are the educated ones, so they're the ones that can speak English, and most likely the level of intelligence and how to contribute also to our society, it's impossible that these kinds of people cannot contribute. As well, it would teach us to be more, of course, we are more well-known as the hospitality capital of the world, as Filipinos. So we have yet also to learn this lesson together with them. It's a two-way lesson learning.
All right. Lastly, your group has been campaigning for this initiative. Please walk us through the activities in connection with this move.
Oh, it's just the same philosophy in terms of congruence in building farming communities and uplifting lives. I mean, the same philosophy that governs us together with our cry or our passion to actually send this message to our government to accommodate Afghan refugees and make the Philippines also as part of this positivity in doing good in the world in general.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon, Diego Jose Ramos.
Stanley.
Have a good day.
Thank you.